girls. I'm back. I was in Nassbrück at the MS center for 3 weeks. I'm home now for a couple of days. I must say I missed you a lot, really, really. And you also missed me. Yes, I was glad to hear that. But I'm really glad I did it, because it was very interesting. I learned a lot. I feel that physically they helped me, so it was a great experience. I also learned a lot from the people who were staying there too. It was pretty confrontational, because I arrived there and, well, almost everybody was in a wheelchair. Me, another guy who was a little younger than me, and then at the end I met a woman. She was 70, and she, well, we did a walk. We went for a little walk around the block there. So I was really happy to see her, because it's possible that you get to be 70 and you can still walk. And that was really good for me to see, because most of the other people were in, well, almost everybody was in a wheelchair. So yeah, of course that scares me a little, but you never know. It can go one way, it can go the other way. We'll see. But the good thing is that I learned so much, especially from the other patients. Problems we share, other problems, things they do, things they learned, how to cope with certain problems. It was really, yeah, super interesting. Really nice people, braver people than me, no doubt. But I learned a lot from them, and I'm really thankful that they were so kind and so open about all different kind of problems. It was really, well, just being with a lot of people who live with your condition, who understand what it is, mentally is really, really healthy to do this. So everybody who's watching that has MS and is doubting if they should go to Melsbrook or to a center for people with MS, I would say do it, because you learn so much. And not only from all the doctors and nurses, but also and mostly of the other patients. And I learned a lot of ways how to deal with certain problems. So, thank you to Patrick, Luc, Jarno, Mathieu, and a lot more people, of course. I learned a lot from them. But what did I do all day? Well, every morning when the nurse came, I got one of these forms with my planning of the day, and every hour there was something else I had to do. Also, when I came in, I told them I want to do as much as possible. I want to learn as much as possible. So they gave me a really, really busy schedule, and I did it all. And I'm really glad I did, because I learned so much. They were really, really nice people, and the good thing is they have so much experience with MS that, well, it made it really easy. They understood all my problems. They found things that I didn't know anything about, or they explained a lot. So I'm gonna tell you, like, this day, what did I do? So in the morning at 9:30, I started with fitness, then ergo, that's kind of an occupational therapy. Then hydro swimming, cool. I also had an ice bath there, really cool. You have to sit in a bath and they throw ice on you all over, and it's really good. Your legs go numb for a while, but then afterwards you feel a lot more, because the feeling in my legs is not what it used to be, but yeah, really cool. After lunch, kine, it's another kind of physical therapy, then the therapy for my balance. After that, I saw an urologist for, you know, the peeing problem, which is to be, which they can help. I have some medication now, I didn't know it existed, but the peeing now is a lot better, yes, which is great. So it goes on and on. I have a lot of things. I also had music therapy. So it was together with a very kind lady. And then she played on a piano and you had to sit at a different piano and you had to play along. But it's a lot of fun. So it's also a lot on the psychological factors. They work with that. You also see a psychologist, a neuropsychologist. They test your, how good your memory works and stuff, how the links in your mind work. So, that was kind of confrontational because, my memory is really not so good, clearly. But it could be worse. You have a social service. They helped me for my driver's license. I have to get new kind of driver's license, but they filled out all the papers. They gave me whole, you know, system, what I have to do, who I have to contact. But, well, they did most of the work. So now I just have to see one more doctor. I have to fill in a paper and then I can, get a new license. So yeah, it was really busy, but really, really interesting. Sometimes quite confrontational because, yeah, they you know, look for all your little problems, and some problems I didn't know that were a problem or a problem. But yeah, you can work on it. Like my balance is really bad, but I did a lot of balance exercises. It was, yeah, not easy, and I was really tired all the time because it was really, really hard and they pushed me, but really good, because now after 3 weeks I really feel that my balance is a lot better. Remember the first movie that I tried to stand on one leg? Watch. Doing it. Brilliant, right? I couldn't do that a month ago and now I can. So yeah, I really feel physical, I'm better than before I went in. Yeah, and I learned so much. That's the most important thing. And last time I told you when I returned from Elsbruck, the meadow would be mine. Ta-da! And it is. Yes. I'm not gonna tell you too much about my plans yet because, well, I still have to make them. But the first thing I had to do was get a little trailer to put on the meadow because if people come with certain health conditions, I needed a place where they could be inside, eat something, drink something. So that was the first thing I had to do. And I did it. Yes, yesterday. I'll show you. But first things first, to get the trailer all the way to the back of the meadow, well, I'm making a kind of a pathway, a strip, to be able to push it all the way to the back.
Well, it's big, yes, which is great, but a lot of work. So I'm making an entrance for my little caravan. I don't know the word. I've gotten until here. This is what I still have to do. This is what I'm doing it with. My neighbor fixed it. Thank you, neighbor, and thank you, person who lent it to us. But I'm starting to realize it's gonna be a lot of work. Yes, but that's a good thing, because hopefully I'll find people who want to join me in my little project. And then, well, we'll have a lot of fun. Yes, moving on. We'll see in a few hours if this is enough. I'll show you then.
And sure, it was enough. It wasn't easy, but good enough.
Come on, put your back into it.
Het wiel staat niet goed precies, denk ik. Voorwiel, ik denk dat we nog iemand nodig hebben, Alexander.
And with a little help from my friends, we got the job done. And after all that hard work, it was time for a little break. And I discovered where the term trailer trash comes from. So after my holiday, I can really start with the project of Land of the Silver Lining, and I'll let you know where you have to be. Hope to see you then.
Oh baby,